ladies and gentlemen, I think it's about time we started to shake things up a little bit. Who is ready? Who in this room is ready to see some pitches? Nobody. Right. I certainly am. I'm sure you are as well. So remember, let's just rewind a little bit. Two days ago, roughly about 40 to 50 different teams put all their brains together and tried to create within 24 hours an app. Okay, the theme was an open theme, so they could do it exactly as they wished. But then they also pitched yesterday to a group of mentors and investors as well. And we've come up with 7 different teams on this stage, ready to pitch in front of you guys, in front of our investors, and I believe in front of the world, because we're also live streaming online as well. So let's just see exactly what they're going to win if they win. Okay. So first of all, in third place. Okay. The third place team will win themselves in cash $1,000. I think that's pretty good. Do you not think that's pretty good? I think if I just threw out $1,000, I'm sure you would all be grabbing those dollars, wouldn't you? Yes, you would. But hey, second place, guess what the team's going to win? Team in second place will win themselves $2,000 in cash. My friend, if I gave you $2,000 right now, I'm sure you will be jumping for joy, screaming in the air, taking your clothes off, and very happy indeed. Please don't do that. Right. And in first place, team will win themselves $3,000 in cash. And that's absolutely, and that's given by shift, split, conference. Also, all three winners, will win a hosting credit from IBM worth $144,000. Okay, so that's hosting credit. Also, DigitalOcean will be giving out $1,400 in hosting credit. Hosting credit, okay, it's not cash. This is hosting credit, which is good. Also, Amazon, they'll also be giving $1,500. In cash. So quite a lot to play for, quite a lot. The stakes are quite high for the winners here of the hackathon. Right, let's just now introduce our jury members who will be on stage and listening to these pitches and then afterwards asking questions. Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, if you'd like to put your hands together for our judges. First of all, number one is Hannah Powell from Trello. Would you like to come out? We also have Brian White as well. We also have Philip Dubosky. And we also have Vladka Shibosh. Okay, so here's the drill. This is how it works. 3 minutes and 3 minutes only on stage to pitch their big idea. Now pitch some of the great pitches. Most of the great pitches are actually less than 3 minutes. 3 minutes. After that 3 minutes, I will actually jump in and ask them to stop. So if they practice well and they know what they're doing, 3 minutes will be fine. Then after that, our jury members we'll ask questions, dig deeper under the idea, under the concept, and find out a little bit more about what they're actually doing and see if there's any substance to what they're doing. Also, you guys, I want you guys to get involved as well. So use the hashtag #ShiftSplit, #ShiftSplit. If you've got any questions or maybe ideas or views or opinions of what you see here on this stage, please throw them out to the world on Twitter, and then we can see for ourselves what everybody else is thinking of the pitches here. Okay, guys, are you ready? I'm sure you are. Before we go any further, some of us have already seen you on stage already. It would be fantastic if you could just say who you are and what you do and who you represent.
Okay, I'll go first. I'm Ahmed. I am the Director of Product Partnerships at Trello.
I'm Brian. I'm Director of Engineering at Intercom.
Hi, it's Philip. I'm the Manager in Deutsche Telekom's Innovation Hub called Hubron.
Hi, my name is Vladka. I'm working as a Project Manager in Mobile Agency 5. We are the sponsor of this event, and we have the office in New York and Zagreb, and we have more than 100 people, awesome developers and designers.
Wonderful. Okay, and I'm sure each and every one of you here, I want to say you've seen a lot of pitches, a lot of ideas. Probably every day you get pitched all the time, and this is no different here in Split. Are you ready? I'm sure you are. Remember, some of the teams that are up on stage perhaps haven't pitched their ideas. Well, no, they haven't pitched their ideas because they came up with it over the last few days. But it may be the first time they've actually presented or done anything like this in such a glorious venue and such a large crowd as well. Okay, here we go with number one, our first team of the Hackathon 2016. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for team number one, which is HTTPS.
In the center of our lives are events. You can look at this picture, and if you look closely, you can see an event in the center of the picture. Seems not.
Try this.
Ah, thank you. Oh, two. Okay. So, again, you can see an event in the center. Bounded by different types of users. So, if you can imagine yourself as one of the users, why would you use our app? So, imagine if you wanted to go and play football. You need a team, that's a team sport. You need players, and you don't have enough friends wanting to play that today in the afternoon football. So, you post the event by our application, as you will see here on the demo preview. And of course, when you make an event, it broadcasts in real time in a nearby area, and you can find volunteers to go and play football with you. Or, for instance, if you want to go to a concert, and none of your friends listen to that type of music, you can broadcast an event and find people who want to go to the concert with you, because nobody likes to go to the concert alone. So these are some of the features that we implemented. That's creating events, posting it on the web, creating contact lists, even 3D events. Also, aside from the web, we made an Android application, mobile application, and that does everything that the web does, just on the native interface. So the technologies that we used are the .NET framework, specifically Web API. We hosted the application using Azure services. And on the front, we use the Android.js. For the mobile, we use the Android. Also, some external services that we used are for the administration support, the intercom, thank you, and the Autodesk for 3D events. You can see as a sample of the 3D event that we mocked up on the hackathon, but you can do any type of 3D event you wish. Take your questions now.
So there we are, HTTPS. Right, let's hear from the jury exactly what they thought and the questions they have.
Okay, so I have a question regarding the features that you have been developing during these 2 days. So have you managed to develop all the features that you planned or not? Can you say at least a couple of key features that you have developed that user can use in the app?
Well, I will give you...
So maybe 80% of the features are complete. So the web application is mostly complete, Android also, but there are some stuff missing, the additional things like those 3D events. That's something that we only did a quick demo. But I would say that 80% of the application is complete. Yeah.
What is that 80%? What actually did you do in the 2 days that you were here? So you showed us 3D events, but you're saying those don't work?
Yeah, you could see here the process of adding new event. So there's other social network things like friends list, events list, Google Maps display. So that's mostly it.
So you built the basic social networking stuff, broadcasting event, getting subscriptions to the event. Does the mobile app, do you push out notifications for events nearby you?
No, it's not. That's one feature we didn't implement, so it's not real-time updates.
Okay.
You have to ping the server to get new data.
Why are you better than Facebook events, even right, other websites? What's your unique selling proposition?
It's mostly that you can, in real-time, for example, you have a you're somewhere and you have 2 hours of free time, you have to wait somewhere, so you just broadcast a quick event and that's it. It's not an alternative to Facebook events, it's just pushing out small, quick events, that's it.
Difference a bit. Facebook needs a friend. You must be friend for someone to call you, event you on some event. Here is anyone can make some event, anyone can say which round of he can push every people who is subscribed to that type of event, and they will see event and they can attend to be.
I think it's very
difficult.
It's like a low friction, easy kind of social connection. What was the hardest bit,
technically
speaking, to implement?
Techniques. On Azure, we build a web API. This is RESTful, and we build a SQL Server also on Azure, and with Serum we will plan to use communication by Google to push notification on Android device. We in Hackathon not build an iOS app, but if we'll continue to develop this, we'll work it.
It's very cool.
What did you have before you came to the hackathon? Was it just the idea, or did you have sketches, mockups, and code, anything like that?
No, we have only idea. We are one of the team who push 150 Git commits in one day and four branches.
You're doing really great, so just relax. So if you win, how will you spend the money? How will you invest the money? Where?
It depends.
And the next question actually, so five of you are here, and so what are the roles? How many developers do we see here? Do you have designer?
All of us are still in the college. And some of us work also on some companies, but we are mostly students. And
who made the design of the app?
Three of them. This design is we have not a perfect designer. We almost use the stuff and frameworks to build some nice look for us, but we manage that.
Okay, so apart from money, which is obviously for product development, right? What do you need to move the thing forward, to scale? Do you need some other resources?
Of course.
Do you need more people, advice, whatever?
I mean, this is mostly our core idea, so that's it, basically. There are no other plans or improvements.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for HTC. You can leave the stage, my friend. You can leave the stage. Thank you.
really good, yes, to stand here.
There you go, a team, they a couple of days, nothing at all. They came here with nothing at all except one small idea, which they've grown into something, hopefully, that might win them a lot of money, but they're not quite sure how they're going to spend, what they're going to spend the money on, or maybe more importantly, how they're going to split that money. Okay, are you ready? Are you ready for pitch or team number two? Yes, you are. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for our next team. And that simply is Hecklady.
So, hi everyone, I'm Jacob, this is Vario, and we are the Hecklers. We came here to Shift Hackathon to develop an app to solve and improve some of the problems which can happen at conferences. Basically, the main goal was to improve the networking and the communication skills, and also bring people apart attending to the conference a bit closer to the main event. So basically what we built a web application with the RESTful API, and we also integrated Intercom's API for some push messages. So about the app, here on the screen you can see the welcome page. We added integrations to Twitter, Google, and GitHub. Once you logged in, you actually get to the dashboard. On the dashboard, at each conference can have different events. You get a list of all the events which are actually happening at the conference. And each of those events is an entity for itself. So each of those events has actually an own detail page. And on that page, you get basic information, like the name, the speaker, for an event like a talk, some basic information. And on the other side, you get the comment feed, which is planned to be instant and or better said live. And also, you can see if you are, in this case, Ivan Burazin, the talk owner, you actually get possibility to answer the Q&A section is where only you are allowed to answer it. So people can ask you questions and only you are allowed to answer them. Also, you can upload files like presentations and documents. For the technologies that we actually used, so the frontend is based on React and Redux. On the backend, it's Django. And for the intercom integration, we also use Celery for the push messages. And yeah, it's RESTful. Also, one note, the design is yes, also custom, it didn't use any framework or something. For the future, as we came to the hackathon, we wanted a small scope application so that basically we can finish it. But as we were developing it and everything, we kind of got some ideas what we could do in the future. So basically, the idea would be the big idea so that conference owners can actually request from us a copy of Confi and white label it and just use it as a platform. Also, of course, improve the in-app messages so that you get notifications on events. And of course, go mobile, because as there's a companion app, it would be really nice to have it native. And that's it. Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen. Okay, let's see what you have to say about the hackers.
Somebody go first.
So I think it's a really good idea. I love the fact that speakers get to keep engaging with their audience through questions. What did make it cut? You said we kept it tight slope. So what features did you get to develop?
So actually, the application is hosted. We weren't allowed to demo it. We wanted to demo it. You can access it if someone wants. We can give you the URL. So it's still live. Also, the API is live, so you can actually input something into the database. It is hosted, so you can sign up, you can log in, and we got so the application connects to the database regarding the event details. So whatever is in the database, you can access it. Only the commenting stuff was a bit tricky because we wanted to make it instant, and that part was too tricky for us, so that's what we didn't finish. And also regarding the intercom, so the backend is ready, only the frontend is missing the integration.
So you said you use intercom for messaging. How is that service in the app?
We were thinking of good use cases for the conference and everything. So we came up with the use case that if a user is some time on the page, let's say for the talk before this, before the page, if he's longer than, I don't know, 15 seconds, he gets segmented. And once he's segmented, the backend is periodically checking all the segments and then pushing a notification. So let's say each user who is, who was longer than 15 seconds on the event, which is a talk, gets a message to the next of this type. Or basically even for this conference, if you have a development pitch, a development demo, the design demo, and the business demo, you can segment each of those users so that he gets a notification for each of those of that type of event. So if you're on a development event and you get a notification for the next development event if you're not there.
When did you start developing this?
Yesterday, 2 days ago.
So yeah. I really like the complexity, the technology, and the progress you did. So thumbs up. But what's the vision? Do you want to give it to other conferences like open source product, or is there something other behind this?
The idea actually was created 3 days ago, so we didn't have a lot of time to think about it.
You were lying.
Excuse me?
Just kidding.
We didn't think that much far, we kind of got to love it, and we'll definitely try to continue on it. So the open source or some financing, I don't know, I can't say anything about it.
You're aware that there are dozens of solutions like this, so you need to find your own leverage.
As I said, we didn't plan anything further for now, but we'll definitely continue developing the app. So to finish all the features and maybe some new, and then we can see if we shall continue with it.
So I assume that you did the web app first and not the mobile app because that was more doable within the 24 hours?
Yeah, so we wanted to do a peg to port it with Lua, but yeah, we were short in time.
So. I really like that you hit like that minimum viable product, like you nailed it down, which is very impressive. And you actually managed to build it in the 24 hours.
Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for... Okay. Absolutely, I love your partner there who says nothing at all the way through it. But I see it. Right, moral support. Right, we move on now to number three. Team number three, ladies and gentlemen, very simply put your hands together for a team known as iApp Builder.
Okay, so hi everyone, my name is Boris, this is our team, and in the 24-hour hackathon we have created AirCloud. So, as we all know, urbanization is increasing rapidly, and with that comes a great deal of environmental problems. And one of the biggest of them is the air quality. Air quality can cause anything from minor irritation to serious diseases and even death. And this especially affects people who have respiratory or cardiovascular diseases. Current monitoring methods are really expensive and impractical for general public to use. So this is an overview of how the solution would work. We would have an embedded air quality sensor that is connected to the smartphone, and we would have public air quality sensors which are scattered all over the city, and they send their data to the server and display it on the public web for everyone to see. This is what we have built in the 24 hours. We have an embedded Arduino device, which communicates with the mobile application, which is a hardware mobile application built with Cordova, Ionic, and other regular web technologies. We also have a proxy mobile application, which actually simulates the work of a stationary air quality monitoring station. It is connected to the server, which is built atop of Microsoft ASP.NET web technology. And we also have a public web application that displays all of that data. So this is the device we built, and it measures carbon monoxide, volatile organic compounds, humidity and temperature, encodes it, and sends it over Bluetooth to our mobile application. Inside the mobile application, users can connect, view all of the information in real time, as well as see a friendly and easy to understand metric with color coding so they can immediately see what the air quality is. We collect all of the data and save it on the device for statistical analysis, and we offer users an overview of their air quality. Users also have access to the heat maps, so they can see the air quality in different parts of the city, and we also integrated advanced intercom API features for customer care and direct communication. This is our public web application that also displays the heat map, but has more options for displaying that heat map, and it is available for public to see, even if they don't have the device itself. So all in all, in these 24 hours, we have built an Arduino device. We have built a mobile application, a proxy mobile application, and a server application which serves data to the public application and the mobile application. It was really intense. We had over 200 Git commits and a whole lot of fun. So if you're interested, you can check out our repository. If you see us later, you can ask us any questions or see the application. And we want to thank everyone for attention. And if judges have any questions, we are happy to answer them. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am the
So, what did you have before you came here?
Okay, so before we came here, we only had the components for the device. Actually, these components have been lying around my house for the last year or so. And this idea came to us like a few months before, but we didn't really have time to realize it because we had some other project and stuff. And this hackathon was like a perfect opportunity to work on it and to do something and to make something usable.
So it's Arduino C, so Arduino Nano, and really good hustle on getting done so quickly. What do you think people would use that data for? Like, what kind of decisions would you make if bad air quality affected you?
Okay, so
for example, if a person wants to buy a new apartment and has respiratory disease, he wants to find an apartment where the air is as clean as possible. Or for example, you may want to, you have some daily routines. For example, you go to job by walk, and you want to learn, you want to find out the path that has the cleanest air and such things. Or for example, you want to find a perfect park for your children to play. That's some of the usages we came up to.
Okay, so I came to you from Krakow in Poland, which is now in the top three most polluted cities in the world. So the air is like black dirt and people are wearing masks. And we even organized the hackathon, anti-pollution hackathon, with some kind of similar solutions. So it's a pretty good market, pretty good idea, keeping my fingers crossed. But the question is, who is your end customer? Who will install this in the building? Who will buy this product? How do you want to distribute this?
So the product itself, actually anyone could buy it, anyone who cares, I don't know about his health or anything, but the main customers are really people who have respiratory or cardiovascular diseases, because, for example, increased concentrations of some gases can cause hypersensitivity and other stuff which really affects them. So we think that would be our main customers. So another component would be the public air quality nodes which would be installed over the city. So the end customer for that would be, for example, governments or regulatory bodies who have control over regulatives, laws and stuff that's connected to air quality.
I'm happy to connect you with this Internet of Things anti-pollution movement from Poland. So,
yeah, thank you. Thank you.
And how accurate is the data in the mobile app? It's all the statistics that we saw.
Okay, so we are currently using off-the-shelf sensors, which can be bought by anyone. So they are not really precise, and we do not employ any complicated calibration techniques. But the thing is with these sensors that they can provide an indication whether the air is good, bad, or moderate. The end user, most often, they don't have to know the exact concentration because they don't know what to do with those concentrations. They really want to know whether the air they're breathing is safe. So these sensors can be accurate in that way. But if we employ some of the calibration techniques, for example, if we use like high-tech device for reference measurements, we can calibrate these to be as similar as the reference device. Or if you use exact concentrations of gases in the clean room, then we can also calibrate it to be much more precise than now.
And the app would wouldn't be free, if I understood right.
So the application itself would be free, but the device, of course, would not be free. So our main product would be the device.
The one thing that you guys can't see, but it's actually updating in real time, the air quality. So like all the numbers are changing as we were passing it down, even when I just take it and move it around, which is really cool. How did you implement that?
I'm sorry, I didn't hear.
How did you implement the real-time functionality, and what is the mobile app built in?
Okay, so the mobile app is built with Cordova. There's Ionic on top of it, and we're using some Cordova plugins to communicate over Bluetooth. So what happens is that the sensor actually collects the data every second or so, and then sends the data over a Bluetooth bridge to the mobile phone. Mobile phone actually listens to the Bluetooth and waits for the data. When the data arrives, it's just pushed to the view, and you have real-time data.
It makes it a lot more compelling. It's really cool.
Yeah.
You are using Bluetooth Low Energy, I guess, yeah?
Currently, we're not using Bluetooth Low Energy, but in the future, we are definitely going to use it. We are currently using the old Bluetooth 3.0 to communicate, but there's no problems just connecting another module to it.
Okay, so how energy effective is it right now? How long a single sensor can operate without changing a battery?
Yeah, since this was a hackathon, we didn't do much optimization for battery life and stuff. We didn't measure how long it could run on battery, but in the future we could implement sleep mode after it collects the measurement. We could optimize it on many different places to save up energy. And by some of our estimates, with enough optimization, it could run for days, because it's not really an energy draining device.
So you have a vision.
Cool.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, chance again for Ariane.